Hello, Charles.
Hi, Michael. How are you doing?
I'm doing okay.
Good.
It's exciting to be getting to talk about reinforcement learning.
Reinforcement learning. It's my favorite type of learning.
Is that true?
It is true.
Wow. I like machine learning.
I like machine learning too, but of all the kinds of machine learning, reinforcement learning is my favorite kind of learning.
So how about giving the opportunity for the students in the class to learn about reinforcement learning by having us tell them about it?
Ooh, let's do that. You first.
All right. We're going to build on the stuff you told us about last time.
You mean the fantastic, well-defined, and well-formalized stuff that we talked about last time?
Yes, it was fantastic, and it laid the groundwork for what I would like to talk about. So you set up Markov decision processes, and I'm going to talk about what it means to learn in that context.
Excellent.
So I find it useful to start off by thinking about a reinforcement learning API, like application programmer interface. So what you talked about is this box here, the idea of being able to take a model of an MDP, which consists of a transition function, T, and a reward function, R, and it goes through some code and, you know, comes out and a policy comes out, right? And a policy is like pi, it maps states to actions. And that whole activity, what would you call that? What would you call the problem of or the approach of taking models and turning them into policies?
Maybe I'd call them planning.
Yeah, that's what I was hoping you would say.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Now, we're going to talk about a different setup here. We're still interested in spitting out policies, right? Figuring out how to behave to maximize reward. But a learner is going to do something different. Instead of taking a model as input, it's going to take transitions. It's going to take samples of being in some state, taking some action, observing a reward, and observing the state that is at the other end of that transition. All right? And I put a little star on that to say, well, we're going to see a bunch of these transitions.
Hmm.
And using that information, we're going to, instead of computing a policy, we're going to learn a policy.
I see. So we call that learning.
Yeah, or even reinforcement learning.
Mm. By the way, what makes it reinforcement learning?
That's a question.
It's not a good question, but it's a question.
I was going to say good question, but it's not that it was a bad question. It's that I don't have a particularly good answer for it. So maybe we need another slide to discuss that.
Okay.